If you have been watching the news recently, you would have seen many headlines stating that eating processed meat and red meat leads to cancer. With many news networks all around the world jumping onto this and suggesting we all stop eating meat because we're all going to die because of it, it's time to actually look hard at this report and really understand what the research shows. First off, we need to establish the definitions for what red meat and processed meat are, because for many people this might be quite unclear. Processed meat means anything which has been salted, smoked, cured, or had any other method of preserving applied to it. Basically, anything which has been modified to extend its shelf life. This means things such as ham, corned beef, canned meat, bacon, pepperoni, sausages, and so on are defined as processed meat, whereas mincing beef, for example, doesn't make it a processed meat. Red meat, on the other hand, means meat such as beef, lamb, pork, horse, goat, veal, or meats which were a dark red colour before you cooked them. Processed meat has been placed into Group 1, which is defined as the exposure circumstance entails exposures that are carcinogenic to humans. Other things in Group 1 are ethanol and alcoholic drinks, oral contraceptive pills in certain circumstances, solar radiation, the uses of sunbeds, secondhand smoking, and smoking. Red meat has been placed into Group 2A, which means there's limited evidence of carcinogenicity in humans, but there is sufficient evidence in experimental animals. These groups only actually show how confident we are in certain things causing cancer, not how much they actually cause cancer. During the process of either salting, curing, or any other sort of preserving treatment, scientists found that something bad happens during this process, which is the build-up of carcinogenic chemicals. The report also found that pan-frying, barbecuing, or grilling tend to produce the highest amount of these chemicals. The report found that those who eat the most processed meat have around a 17% higher risk of developing bowel cancer compared to those who ate the least amount of processed meat in the study. This might sound like quite a big risk between those who eat the most and those who eat the least, but this is where the confusion comes into play, because 17% is a relative risk. We need to look at this in absolute terms, not relative. Putting this into easier absolute terms, on average, 61 out of 1,000 people will develop bowel cancer at some point throughout their lifetime in the United Kingdom. This study points towards those who eat the lowest amount of processed or red meat, on average, seeing 56 out of 1,000 people developing bowel cancer at some point throughout their life. On the other hand, those who eat the most will see 66 out of 1,000 people develop bowel cancer on average. That's 10 more cases between those who eat the least and those who eat the most. Basically, like most studies, this one too is using scaremongering tactics by releasing the relative risk compared to the much smaller absolute risk. In the United Kingdom, almost 20% of all cancer cases are linked to smoking, whereas 3% of cases are said to be caused by red and processed meat. This means although eating significant amounts of processed meat and smoking are in the same group, the differences in risk are very extreme. If no one smoked in the UK, there would be 64,500 fewer cases of cancer every year, compared to 8,800 fewer cases of cancer if no one ate any processed or red meat. There are quite a few faults with this report, such as the fact that the whole diet and lifestyle of those studies was not taken into consideration. They only looked at how much people were eating processed and red meat. For example, those who eat more processed meat are said to be far less active, have a higher BMI, tend to not eat as much nutrient-rich fruit and vegetables, and be three times more likely to smoke, making processed meat potentially a marker, not a maker, of an unhealthy person. Taking processed meat out of your diet isn't going to completely get rid of your risk of bowel cancer. Getting checked for bowel cancer after the age of 50 can decrease your bowel cancer risk by half, for example, which will do a lot of good for you. With only a difference of 10 out of 1,000 people between those who eat low and high amounts of processed and red meat, it is fair to say giving up smoking, for example, is going to reduce your overall risk of cancer than fully cutting out meat from your diet. But it is recommended to perhaps cut down on your overall meat consumption. Meat, though, is good in moderation, as it is a good source of protein, iron, and zinc. In the end, Cancer Research UK says it all comes down to moderation. Eat plenty of fibre, fruit and veggies, cut back on your red and processed meat consumption, they suggest a limit of 70 grams a day, limit your alcohol intake, or don't drink at all, and never smoke, as that is always bad for you, and you should find your risk of cancer will decrease. Thank you very much for watching this video, and be sure to subscribe for future videos.